What is the code?
Well, I think it's probably different for everybody. You ask for no quarter and you give none.
You know, don't hit a guy while he's down.
Rarely, if ever, do I throw the first punch.
No punching after the linesmen get in.
You try not to grab a guy at the end of a shift.
You know, that's it. It's over.
It is one of hockey's great paradoxes. In a game where intimidation and aggression play vital roles are the concepts of code, honor, and respect.
You know, I think that the one thing that people don't fully understand about the rule is there's more honor to it than you recognize at first blush.
If a fighter's hands are hurt, for example, he will tell a guy, I can't go tonight, which is remarkable to me. There is a code, and when a fight is ready to stop, it stops. You almost don't need linesmen.
You never take advantage of another guy if he's in a tough spot, if he's got a sore hand, or he's just roughed up in any way. Or if it's just not the right time. You don't jump a guy, you just don't take advantage of another individual in that circumstance.
Today, Stu Grimson is a law student at the University of Memphis. Time and distance have given him a unique perspective on the life he once knew as one of hockey's most feared enforcers.
Hockey fighting, it's part of the game, but it's not carried over. He said there's no hatred of the other man. And Stu Grimson was a very religious man, and he felt that fighting still could be balanced into his religion, because he said, you know, a fighter is a protector, and if you're a Christian as I am, he said, who better to protect someone than a Christian?
A lot of us that do or have done that, we know one another, and we know each other on a personal level, which you might think kind of takes away from it, but it's quite the opposite, because when we're on the ice, it's all business. And the neat part is, when it's all said and done out there, it's left there, it's forgotten there, and that's where it remains. You could see those guys on a personal level outside the game, and it was like it never happened. In fact, it was almost like you had this rapport because it did happen.
Well, they could have two fights in this game, probably still go out together afterwards.
No, you're right. They both understand the job that they're supposed to do once the puck drops.
Early on in my career, I fought Stu Grimson quite a few times, and then we ended up being teammates in Anaheim. He was the first guy that I gravitated to, the first guy I got along with, and certainly there's that respect or some kind of bond, I guess, that you, just from battling somebody over and over again, that you have this instant bond.
One time Stu Grimson was telling me he was in a battle with Jimmy McKenzie, and at one point as they were brawling, he said, you had a little Italian for lunch today, didn't you, Jimmy? And McKenzie apologized in a fight because he realized he had garlic breath and they were battling and they were in close quarters. And again, you know, it seems silly, but I think that explains the culture of the sport, that these guys are great guys that just, you know, they have to fight. That's part of their game.
And nowhere is the measure of these men seen more clearly than when the game is left behind.
The guys that I've known over the years, the guys that I played with, and the tough guys that I continue to cover and to meet are, generally speaking, the nicest people you can run into.
There we go. All right, enjoy the game, okay? All right, bye. Nice to meet you.
Eat the ducks, please.
Yeah, we'll work on that.
Thank you.
Nicest guys in the league. And, you know, those are the guys I'd love to have living next door to me, or the guys that I'd love to invite to my barbecue. They're incredible human beings. Darren McCarty in today's game, you know, another example of that.
You had to work hard to get here, work hard to stay here, but you sort of appreciate along the way, and it's just... it makes you feel good to give back.
I think the bottom line, when you get it down to the foundation, all the tough guys are sacrificing themselves for the team. And they realize everything they do is to make sure their teammates are safe. It's to protect their teammates. And I think that carries through off the ice, too.
They're always the first guy to volunteer to go visit sick kids.
They're polite. They're giving.
They're the first guy to get involved in charity because they are fighting not for themselves, but for the logo, for the team, for smaller teammates. And this is what makes them so extraordinary as human beings.